meer bereiken? Or can you talk about?
Fruit.
About fruit. Say, Marijke, what fruit do you have there?
Orange.
Orange and the?
Nachi.
And the nachi. Say.
Ah! Orange and the nachi.
There we go. Now you got it.
Say.
Do you like fruit?
Yes.
Do you like it? Oh, nami nami. And tell me, is fruit good for your body?
Sugar for me.
You also like sugar. So what is good for your body? Sugar or fruit?
Sugar.
It's sugar. Fruit. But what is the first thing you need to eat?
Fruit, then sugar.
Fruit, then sugar. Why first fruit?
Because it makes you healthy. Then eat fruit.
That's it makes you healthy.
Mm-hmm. And also, you have to eat
sugar. And sugar makes you sweet. There we go. Okay, so if fruits make you healthy, do you think the rule that you need to eat fruit every day is a good one or a bad one?
Good one.
A good one. Are all rules good?
Yes.
All of them?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it easy to follow them?
Yep.
Really?
Maybe it's some.
Maybe, sometimes. Sometimes it's easier than other times, eh? Yes, you're right. Talking about fruit, did you know that the Bible has fruit?
Huh? Yeah.
Yes, the Bible has fruit inside it. Did you know that?
I can smell.
What do you want to smell? The Bible?
Yes. Bible.
Does the Bible smell like fruit?
Green.
Yes, it does. So let me read you the fruit of the Spirit.
Wait a minute.
For what?
This paper made of fruit.
Is this paper made of fruit?
Mm-hmm. Oh,
that's quite cool.
This paper. Fatty made of fruit.
Wow, that's so cool. Let me read you the fruit that it says in the Bible. Is that okay? So the first one is
this one,
love.
This one you first. This one is this orange. Fatty to make papers.
Do they take orange to make papers?
Yep.
That will smell really nice. Can smell. I read what's on the paper first?
Smell.
Oh, that's not smell it first. Okay, hold on. Mmm, it smells like old books.
And
orange. I smell the orange. I smell it. Okay. So the Bible fruits
are also made of nurses.
They're also made of nurses, is it? Okay. Can I read the Bible fruits to you?
Smell this way.
I did smell that one.
Now smell this one. It smells that orange now.
I smell the orange. It smells lovely.
And this.
Now you smell that one while I read the fruits to you. Okay. So the first fruit is love.
Yeah.
Love. And then the second one is joy.
Joy.
Can you say it loud?
Joy.
Joy. And then we have peace.
Peace.
And then we have patience.
Patience.
Kindness.
Kindness.
Goodness.
Goodness.
Faithfulness.
Faithfulness.
Gentleness.
Gentleness.
And self-control.
Self-control.
These are big words, but that is the fruit that we have that the Bible gives us. We call it the fruits of the Spirit.
Yeah. And it is like a fruit party.
And it smells like a fruit tree. And it stands in Galatians 5, verse 22.
Yes.
Yes. So guys. Gather your mother, gather your father, your whole family, and read Galatians 5 verse 22 about all the different fruits that you get when the Holy Spirit is in charge of your life. And ask your mother or your grandfather or whoever to explain to you what these fruits mean in your life and how it will make a difference in your life. Okay?
Yeah.
And then, before we go, can we pray before we go?
Yes.
Oh, are you going to pray with me? And then at the end we're going to say amen.
Yes.
Okay, close your eyes. Let's go, guys. So thank you, God, that we can learn about all the fruits that you give us that make our lives strong and healthy. So go with us this week so that we can be able to have these fruits in our lives and to see how important they are. Thank you very much for everything that you do for us. And we say?
Thank you.
Amen. We say amen. Thank you, God. Amen. Okay, then you say bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, guys. Have a nice week. We'll see you again later.
Now I don't need the nachi.
Hey?
Now I don't need this.
Now you can eat the nachi. Bye, guys. Have a nice week.
Bye, that's happiness week.